you guys. Sorry about that. Yeah, thank God I made that safe state. Yeah, in between episodes, I did check on the, the mystery cards in here. And yeah, just to make sure I wasn't wrong about that. But yeah, as far as this Mew, the Phantom Mew, the GB Mew with mystery attack, yeah, the damage can indeed go up to 120. And like I said, the random status effect, it can, like, you know, poison or confuse just randomly. So, but yeah, I just wanted to make sure, like, it didn't go up to potentially 150 damage or something. I wasn't misinforming you guys. But anyway, with that being done, let's, yeah, we've beaten the Grandmasters. Let's get our legendary Pokemon's cards, guys. Here we go. The four legendary Pokemon cards float, glowing in the air. And Blood and Mutton got the legendary card, Moltres. Heck yeah. Yeah, and we've seen this before with Courtney, Fire Giver. Very good. Alright, and we also get the legendary card Articuno, level 37. Yeah. Very nice. One thing I don't think I remembered to mention is that, another key feature of all these legendary Pokemon cards is that, they don't have any weakness. So, yeah, that can definitely make them all, you know, pretty hard to take out. But at the same time, you know, once you finally get them, that's probably the best thing about them is that, yeah, they're not weak to any type in this game, so. Alright, and we get the legendary card, Dragonite, level 41. Yeah, I don't think I think the video cut off before I talked about this one, but, anyway, when you put Dragonite into play, yeah, remove, 2 damage counters from each of your Pokemon. Yeah, very good. We saw this from, Ronald. One good thing you can do with this Dragonite is, use Alakazam's damage swap and, you know, just manipulate the damage counters to where you have, you know, yeah, like, let's say your active Pokemon has 60 damage on it. You know, you can use damage swap, you know, keep 20 on that, put 20 on, like, Dragonair and 20 on something else. Yeah, and then Dragonite, there you go. You heal all the damage on your side. Pretty good. Pretty good combo. The legendary Pokemon cards speak to you. You who have inherited us, great card master. Our master must not forget. Inheriting us does not make you a Pokemon card master. A true Pokemon card master is one who has the skill to use the abilities of the different cards and the courage to duel powerful opponents, and most of all, the ability to love the Pokemon trading card game. No matter what, win or lose, a new journey has begun. Yeah, cards are talking to us. That's amazing, man. But anyway, guys, yeah, the credits will now roll, and that's it. Man, this has been a really fun LP. Really, really fun. I like, you know, I'm really glad I came back to this one. Pokemon the trading card game. It's just fun, man, and this game, you know, it's got great music, it's got, you know, it's basically, you know, kind of like, you know, traditional Pokemon, you know, how you have 8 gems in the Elite Four, basically that, but converted to the Pokemon trading card game. And as far as trading card games go, like, I mean, Pokemon, like, even if you haven't played this game, man, it's, like, so easy to learn and pick up and, you know, just to get used to the energy cards and stuff, and, it's fun, you know, it's almost like Yu-Gi-Oh! Or any other card game, you know, yeah, sometimes you need any little luck or a lot of luck, right? I mean, just take a look at those, all those Grandmaster battles, am I right? But, either way, it's fun, so, I have fond memories of, like, collecting Pokemon, even as a kid. I didn't play for, like, really, really too long, but, like, from base set all the way to, you know, kind of, like, close to Johto, around there, man, and, like, I bought the starter decks, and, it was just a lot of fun. It's just a lot of fun, man. So, even if you've never played Pokemon before, I'd encourage you to just give this game a try, you know, see if you like it. This is one of the best. Now, as far as sequels go and, like, what else we're going to do in this LP, I honestly don't have much else planned for this one, but there is a sequel to this game. Pokemon the Trading Card Game 2. There is like a fan translation, and I actually have that. I might have played it on stream. But we're not gonna do it right away. Like, as far as this goes, like, we're just gonna, you know, sit here and enjoy the fact that this is finale, and we're gonna take a little break, you know, from Pokemon Trading Card Game. And in fact, like, I never really even showed off the Venusaur deck in this game. Like, so, you know, sometime in the future, you know, maybe like 2 or 3 years from now, or whenever I get an inkling to play this game, I'd be up for like replaying this game, you know, from the beginning, and then going with like, I don't know, let's say like the Bulbasaur and Friends deck, or the Charmander and Friends. So, but yeah, thank you all for enjoying my Let's Play of this game. It's fun. Let's read some of these names. Yusuku, Mari, Matsuda, Moto, Yamaguchi. Ah, man. Great game. Project Manager, Yasutaka Kakiseko. Supervisor, Hiroshi Kudo. Yeah. Executive Producer, Hiroshi Yamauchi. Created by Hudson. Yeah, made by Nintendo, Creatures, Game Freak, Media Factory, Hudson Soft. Alright guys, this has been a Let's Play Pokemon Trading Card Game. Alright, until next time. Nah, I'm just kidding, let's see. Let's see what happens, you know, after the Elite Four win. So, yeah, after you have beaten the Grand Masters, you come here back to Mason Laboratory. So, there's a machine here. That's odd. That wasn't here before. First things first, let's save. It's probably a good idea. So let's talk to Dr. Mason and see what he thinks now that we finally inherited the legendary Pokemon cards.
Congratulations, Floodmon 14. I hear you have inherited the legendary Pokemon cards. The strength of a deck does not only depend on a single card, but on how skillfully you are able to use that card. The power of the legendary Pokemon cards depends on you.
Ah. Very true, very true. It's not the engine, it's the pilot. I think that's what Dr. Mason's saying here. You must become a skilled card master. Alright. Hey buddy, this wasn't here before, what's up?
This is the challenge machine created by Dr. Mason. The challenge machine is a powerful card dueling machine. The rules of the game are simple. Choose one deck with which you must duel against 5 computer opponents. If you can defeat the 5 opponents, you win. You can also play to extend your winning streak. Build a deck and give it a try, bud.
Okay. So yeah, that's the thing with this. And believe it or not, some of the people you can actually face here, I'm not actually gonna do it, but I'll do it toward the end of the episode and then just quit out. But just to show you guys, like, some of the people you can face on here are actually pretty skilled. One thing you can do is, now that you've been through the Grand Masters, whether you win or lose, these last 3 mails will be here. So we might as well read them, but, you know. It's me, Dr. Mason. Steve uses Legendary Zapdos. Heal of Thunder and Big Thunder randomly choose a target, so you never know which Pokemon will receive damage. Be sure to look after not only your active Pokemon. That's good advice. Is deck mostly Lightning? Yep. Duel them with your Fighting Pokemon. Mainly the ones that resist electric. Those will probably help you the most, so. Alright. 3 more to go. Oh yeah, I forget we do get a booster pack, so.
Pitch out!
This one has a hurricane, right? Yeah, pretty cool.
Whee!
Jinx, jinx.
Yes, Lee.
Alright. Alright, next mail. 2 more to go. Jack uses Articuno. Legendary Quick Freeze, Paralyze. Yep. Also be wary of his other Articuno's Freeze Drive. Right. That's the same one we have in our deck. This deck mostly should be water, so we'll be weak against lightning. So, alright. What Dr. Mason doesn't tell you is Jack also loves his bulky colorless Pokemon. So if you want, you know, take some Hitmonchans in there and you'd be good to go. Oh, Dragonite. Not bad. Yeah, if I do some post-game stuff, I mean, I'll definitely enjoy that, Mr. Fujiyama.
Still there.
All right. Baldur, and Bogus. Alright. Last mail. The final duels here, I have some information on Rod, leader of the Grandmasters. Legendary Dragonite, the longer the duel takes, the greater the advantages for his deck. Yeah, I never really mentioned it, but, you know, much like Lance, you know, the Elite Four in Kanto, Rod does have dragons, you know, dragons in his deck, so we're talking about, you know, Gyarados, Charizard, you know, Dragonite, you know, stuff like that. So, his workhorse will be his evolution Pokemon. Exactly. So, long story short, you know, kind of do like we did. Defeat his Stratini and Charmanders while they're unevolved, and you'll have a much better shot. So, that's basically what he's saying. Follow this simple strategy of striking early. Right. Yep, go be a part of the legend. Oh, my final gift to you. Aw, thanks, Dr. Mason. A laboratory pack. That's a pretty good trainer card, yeah. Slow, bro. Alright. Okay. Alright, so that's all for that. Anything else I want to show you? So, you may also notice that, where's the album? Is it here? Card album. Here we go. Promotional card. One thing you may notice, depending on how many promotional cards you have and how many you don't, we're actually missing 1, 2, 3 promotional cards. And now, like, the Mystery Attack Mew and the other GB Venusaur, those don't count. Those are considered, like, phantom cards. So you can complete the card album without those cards. And the only way you can get those phantom cards is with the card pop. But, yeah, we are missing, three promotional cards. How do you get them? Where can you get them? Just to let you know, I'll just show you. If you post-game, if you go over here to Ishihara's house, he may want to do a trade. Oh, Ronald's here. But he may want to do a trade with you, so. Oh, congratulations, Pokemon 14. I heard the news. You finally inherited to the legendary Pokemon cards. Don't worry. I'm not going to ask you to trade them. Yeah. Besides, it would be a waste not to use the legendary cards for dueling. Make sure your duels are worthy of the legendary Pokemon cards. Yeah, so post-game here, Ishihara will want to trade with you, and that may be how you get, because I know there's like another art for the surfing Pikachu, so that's one of them. So, let's talk to Ronald here.
Oh, it's you, Flutterman 14. I couldn't believe that I could lose, but now I understand. The fun thing about the Pokemon trading card game is not who wins or loses. I couldn't inherit the legendary Pokemon cards because all that was important to me was winning. But now I understand what's important is to love each card.
Well said, Ronald. Well said.
To use all the different cards to build different types of decks and to play against different people's soul. Shutting my 14. Will you play with me again with all sorts of different decks?
Yeah, you bet, buddy. And this time, I'm not going to lose, buddy. Okay, so Ronald has retired here to Ishihara's house. Is he Ishihara's son? And we saw Nikki here. What's going on? Or is this, or maybe he's just here to study up, you know. I don't know. Thoughts? Theories?
But hey, that's just the theory. A Pokemon trading card game theory. And cut.
Okay, but anyway. I'm just kidding. That hurt my voice to do. The other card place you may want to check for the missing promos you may or may not have is right here at the Challenge Cup. So, every once in a while, now that you've beaten the game, there will be a Challenge Cup going on here. And basically, they offer different promo cards, you know, kind of randomly. So, if you want copies of additional promos you've gotten, like the Cyburn Mewtwo and stuff, yeah, come here every so often and, go through the challenge hall. You know, save before you do it, and then, there you go. Alright, guys, but I think that's gonna be it for me here. This will be the finale of Pokemon Trading Card Game for now. Unless I think of something else I want to show? Yeah, this is gonna be it. I don't know why I came in here randomly to Murray, by the way. I just, you know. But yeah, thank you all for joining me. One thing, like, as far as bonus episodes I may consider doing, Yeah, we only need 12 to fill out the album. I don't know. Maybe I could consider doing that, as well as, yeah, something else I could do just for bonus episodes, you know, just for, like, one or two bonus episodes is, let's see, yeah, I could, you know, put the legendary cards, now that we've got them, you know, put, like, one in each deck, and then, you know, maybe go up against some of the club masters, because, yeah, we do have, like, you know, Articuno now, we do have, you know, Moltres now. Yeah, that could be potentially fun. Just make, like, Yeah, that has potential for a bonus episode, perhaps, you know. Make, like, a, yeah, one of each, you know, fire, water, and electric, and, I guess colorless. And then, yeah. Yeah, that is something. Well, of course, the only thing about that as far as a bonus episode is there's no guarantee I'll draw the card. That's a good point. But yeah, maybe. We'll see. All right, guys. But, you know, for now, yeah, I want to thank you all for joining me. And this has been Let's Play Pokemon the Trading Card Game. Really fun. Yeah. All right. Until next time, guys. Bye-bye.